Here we go. There's a boat time again, I think. And water skiing time. That's my Uncle Kenneth taking film at me, taking pictures of him. That's Junichi and Ray. Ray Pfeiffer. That's Sharon's husband. That's Grandpa Winkle's boat, and that's me out there rowing. Wood boat. Didn't roll very fast. A heavy thing. It's one of those that they used to fill up full of water every spring to make the wood swell up so it wouldn't leak. Grandpa used to paint everything red and white. The cottage is white with red trim. Chairs are white with red tops. Tables were white with red tops. The boat was white with red bottom. The inside was natural wood. Beautiful thing. We swam every day in the summertime. There's Mom even taking a bath in the river. Soap up and dive in. That was my cousin Stanley there in front of Mom. Her brother's youngest son. And there's Elsie and Marion, and then Lonnie and Johnny and Stanley. Pictures of some of the cottages, houses along the river. None of them are there anymore. That's a picture of our house. That was our second house. Mom and Dad bought that and rented it out. I don't know why they'd want to live there on that river. But we had the cottage to go to, so. These are all my cousins out there fishing. There's Lonnie, Elsie and Marion, Mom, Marion looking at us. Hi, Marion. All the people are dead and gone. Even Lonnie's gone. He died a while back. Yeah, we're going to switch pictures here again. There's Dad and Fury, Junichi in the background, me, Pal. Yoshi coming down the steps. That horse put up with anything until he got older. When he became a stallion and got older and started breeding the other horses, he got mean. Very few people could handle that thing, that horse. He's a big baby at that age. He's real young. Summertime, we used to trim his mane. His mane is cut off. In the wintertime, it'd be like 2 foot long. Nah, not quite 2 foot, maybe a foot. Everybody got the bush in the summertime, even horse. There's my Uncle Kenneth with Junichi on the back of it. Dad and me and Junichi and Sal and Miyoshi and Dwayne. Oh, that's Yvonda. And the horse would just sit there, eat the grass. Didn't matter if you ran around him or what. This film goes out of focus a little bit. There's one of the pontoon boats that used to go up and down the river all the time. And people would get on those things and go slow all the way up the river and come back. About a 7 mile, 8 mile stretch. That people could go water skiing on. There's Grandpa Winkel, that's my dad's dad. And Grandma Winkel, my dad's mother, Edwin C. and Florence. And this is right after he had his first stroke. You could barely talk, could hardly walk. It was shortly after that that he had a second stroke and was paralyzed and couldn't talk, and he was bedridden for pretty close to 10 years. Grandma took care of him. That's our raft. That's a homemade raft. 55-gallon drum. Dad built that. I put the wires on it, hang the drums on it. Put that thing in the river and pull it out every fall. Piers would come out of the water so the ice wouldn't take them out in fall. We had a lot of fun on that thing. All you need, a little raft like that and a bunch of inner tubes, man, you can go all day. 1961 Fury, Plymouth Fury. 1960, I think that's a 1960 Plymouth Fury, Dad's car. Our neighbor's house, this is back at home now. And back at the river, different pontoon boat. Mom used to edit this film whenever you make it years ago, when you never knew what was going to get plugged in next to it. Whatever film was there, she put together. So some of these rolls are three or four or five of the little ones put together. One of the first pontoon boats ever made, and I don't remember if it was that blue one or that reddish one that came down. I know one of them had a canvas that went over the top. There's Fury and me driving. And my cousins in it, I think. Lonnie and Stan and John. Oregon Otter, oldest Lonnie, John, and Stanley. Stanley's about a year older than me. That's a 59 Plymouth. Hi-ho, Silver. Anyway, I was saying about that pontoon boat. The first one ever made was, I gotta think of the name. When I do, I'll tell you. I gotta think. Even if I don't remember the name, the first one was, or the first few back in them days were, well, here comes Grandpa, my dad, and Kenneth. Holding on to him so he wouldn't fall down. Like I said, he could barely walk. I wish the film would have been a little clearer here. Here's a little clearer shot. Oh, my grandfather, all my kids' great-grandfather and grandmother, and Uncle Kenneth, and of course, Dad. Here's Gramps. Like I said, that was the last time he was ever able to come out to the cottage. 10 years later, before he died, though. Out of focus film. Here we go, clean it up. Come on, Dan, clean it up. Is it Aunt Miyoshi in the horse? Grandma and the horse. Anyway, back to the pontoon boats. They made them things out of 55-gallon drums, like there they are making them. That 55-gallon drums, just like we made that thing. It was only after that that they started making the pontoons out of aluminum and making boats. The guy that had the patent on that lived right up the river from us, right down the river from us. Because he built the first one, like I said, out of 55-gallon drums, and it was a big thing with canvas on it. All handmade. I grew up with his kid. His kid was Jimmy. Clothing store, suits for men, down in Milwaukee. Popular men's suit place. Here we are all out swimming. Take a dip. You learned how to swim early in those days, because everybody did it. And we're getting double film again. I wonder how many times my mother used the same whole roll of film to take pictures. You know, it doesn't matter much here because it's so blurry anyway, you can't see it. I can't see who's in there. I can tell that's me standing there. Junichi. Here's Dad in his car. There's clearer pictures. Right there is where we used to put the boat in all the time too. Dad had gravel poured in there so that we could put the boat in, and we used to swim over there. It was shallower there because of that. It's the deepest part of the river over there. Right across on the left, I think it was like 20 feet deep in that little cove. One time the dam went out in Thiensville that held all that water up in there, and all the water was gone from the river except for that area. Completely dry. Yeah, outdoor toilet. She must have had to go to the bathroom. And that's the fire pit we used to have all the time, right there on the right side of the pier. That's the back of the cottage, the doorway in, and the stairs going downstairs. Stairs going up to the front porch. I mean, the back porch. Front porch is the riverside. Yeah, 59 and 60. I remember Mom got a 61 station wagon right after this. We used to go down there, I cut that grass every Thursday, because it would be packed full of people over the weekend, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday.